Good evening, happy Sabbath. Thank you for joining us here this Friday evening at the Southern Asian Church. For those of you that are in person, for those of you that are joining us online, it's always a blessing to welcome the Sabbath hours with worship. I see many guests over here. I see our officers from the Southern Asian Church, Southern Asian Division, over here. We are so grateful for your presence worshiping with us this Sabbath. But more than that, I am excited to have the Andrews Academy Band and Strings, I think the strings are at the back, here with us this evening, as well as their director, Ms. Elsie Gallardo-Diaz. We are so grateful for your ministry, for coming over here and ministering to us. I spent about 5.5 years in a house just across the road from Andrews Academy. The house is now gone. But I looked at that building every day. We played tennis in summers, and we used to skate on that tennis court in winter. I don't know if you still do that. Someone used to leave a water pipe on, and we used to skate there in winters. Amazing. I'm not giving you ideas. Oh, no. We're going to get in trouble here. I did not have the privilege of going to Andrews Academy. I was in Ruth Murdoch in the elementary school while my father was studying, and we went back to India after that. But it's always a blessing having you come from Andrews Academy. It feels like a little bit of my home is here this evening. So thank you for making this trip here too. Before we begin our worship, may I invite you, wherever you are, whoever can hear my voice, please bow your heads as we welcome the Lord's presence tonight. Father God, such a blessing to know that right here, wherever we are in this time, as the sun sets, as Sabbath begins, that you have promised a special time of rest for us. And so, Father, as we put aside our week, our activities, our regular schedules, we come to you now, Lord, just us, without anything, without any baggage. And so we pray, Father, as we seek your presence, not just this evening, but this Sabbath, that you will be found. May we learn more of you. May we be drawn closer to you. May we be rejuvenated by your presence this evening, Lord. We thank you once again for your presence. We pray in your name. Amen.
We're so thankful to be here with you guys worshiping and welcoming the Sabbath in a few shortly. We have, as our brother said, this is the symphonic band, and the strings you're going to hear in a little bit. We have been traveling in installments, if you will. We made a stop in Pittsburgh and then New York, and then we were coming from New York today. As you know, lots of traffic and and all those kinds of things, but we're very happy that we made it in time, and thank you so much for your kind welcome and your usual hospitality. I brought the band and the bells in 2019, and we just had a really amazing experience with the church, and we remember you guys fondly when we come this area. So thank you so much. We're going to play three pieces for you. The first one, Be Thou My Vision, which is a very well-known, beloved hymn, Irish origin. And then we're going to play a piece called Rainbow in the Clouds. And this is based on a spiritual that is called God Put a Rainbow in the Clouds. And there is a, let me find my little quote here. The famous writer Maya Angelou, I believe that's her last name, and she said something like the following: God puts rainbows in the clouds so that each of us in the dreariest and most dreaded moments can see a possibility of hope. And I think you may, in different ways, as well as the rest of us, face many challenging situations and in life, but I think every time since the days of Noah, when we see the rainbow, we can remember that there is hope, there is a promise to come. So please enjoy Vida My Vision, and Rainbow in the Cloud.
Thank you.
All right, the next piece is called Reluctant Joys, and this piece is a collection of six African-American spirituals, laments, and plantation songs. I'm going to read you a little bit of what it is about. These are in large part a reflection of the suffering and deprivations slaves had to endure before the emancipation. The slaves obtained in song what they were denied, right, in real life. The salvation and then the release from the daily inhuman torture they had to endure at the hands of their masters. But we can say that these songs became the bedrock of which American music was born. The six songs used in this setting are, the titles may not be known, but the titles are Poor Rosie, Heave Away, Shockalong Jong, The Good Old Way, and There's a Meeting Here Tonight, and Goodbye Brother. And these are presented in a modern setting, as you see with the band, modern band here. And it's a very simple elegance, there's charm, but also with very rhythmic parts. So hopefully you enjoy Reluctant Joys.
Thank you.
While I invite my first two rows of players to go down, strings come up. The group that, as I said, this is Orion Strings. This is the smallest ensemble, orchestral ensemble that we have at our school. These students come every morning, except Mondays, to practice at 7:10. So this is a group of quite dedicated students that have been working together for a while. On Thursday, we had the privilege to go visit Waldwick School in New Jersey and just share some of our music with the younger students. And it's very nice to see how they get inspired about playing instruments and learning and just seeing peers their age that enjoy music as well. So we're going to play three pieces for you. The first of them, it's based on the hymn, It Is Well. And I believe you know the story of this hymn. In case that you may not know it, very briefly, Horatio Spafford was a very wealthy and accomplished man in Chicago. And he was planning a trip with his family, wife and two daughters to England. And in the middle of the journey, the wife and the daughters, they left first. And he was detained for some business. And he said, we'll see you when I get there. But the ship sank in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean. And only the wife survived. And she sent a telegram saying, saved alone. And when Horatio Spafford went to England in another ship, the captain showed him, look, this is the place where your family lost her life. And rather than becoming discouraged or killing himself or despairing or something like that, he decided to put his trust in God. And somehow the words of the hymn, It Is Well, came to him. And it's been an inspiration to countless people who have sang and listened to this song. Something very interesting is that the wife and the husband had more children, and then they moved to Africa, and then started an orphanage. So I think it is going up until today, and they continue their ministry, that they would help anybody who needed help. They wouldn't charge anything. They would just continue helping the people who wanted to be helped. So from tragedy, there's so many instances where blessing comes from many, many years to come. So hopefully you enjoy it as well. Right, this was the prelude from the Holberg Suite by Edward Grieg. Anyone recognize this piece? Not so much. All right, I hope you enjoyed it. It makes me smile. I don't know about you. It really makes me smile. Okay, the next one, the next piece that we're going to play with the strings is Didn't My Lord Deliver Daniel? So beloved African-American spiritual, not only Daniel, but who is the other character that is spoken in this in the spiritual? Anybody know? Jonah in the belly of the whale, right? So we have Daniel, Jonah, and just one more time, this theme of deliverance, of hope in the midst of any circumstances. Didn't my Lord deliver Daniel?
Thank you.
going to ask the rest of the band to please rejoin. Thank you, String, so much.
And while the band is going up at this time, we would like to call forward our deacons to collect an offering of thanks, an offering of worship this evening. What a way to start our Easter weekend, when a large part of the Christian community celebrates and remembers the death and resurrection of Christ, to be blessed by music here talking about redemption, talking about salvation. And so our offering this evening should be from a place of worship, from a place of thankfulness. And I'd like to invite our deacons to come forward.
Vespers concert tonight, but the piece called Joy in All Things. This is based on the hymn Come Christians Join to Sing, one of the most upbeat and happy hymns that we have in our repertoire. In One More Time, I want to thank the Church of Southern Asian for opening your doors one more time, for coming out and spending your time with us tonight. And we hope that we can leave you with a little bit of music in your heart and with a vision of hope and heaven tonight. So thank you so much one more time to a pastor and the minister of music who has been helping us so much, and our brother as well. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Once again, we are truly grateful for your ministry, especially after a day on the road. Thank you so much. I know you all must be tired, but we're so blessed by the energy you brought through your music, the love that you shared through your music. So thank you so much for blessing us again. We do hope every time you are on the East Coast that you will come by Southern Asian. We love having you. We love having your music. As we've come to the end of our worship for this evening, may I once again invite you, wherever you are, to bow our heads in prayer. Father God, we are so blessed with the reminder of your redemption, the salvation that you've given and offered each one of us. And so this weekend, and perhaps every day of our lives, may we celebrate the story of your Son, his sacrifice, and the life that that sacrifice brings for each one of us. Be with us this Sabbath, Lord, as we continue celebrating it with you. And we pray that as we rest tonight, Lord, we will find the rest that we need. We continue to pray for your presence in each of our lives as we leave this place, but never from your presence. We once more pray in your name. Amen. So thank you, everyone that is joining us for worship. Just a reminder, tomorrow our worship service over here will begin at 10 o'clock with Sabbath School, 11 o'clock for our divine service. Also, tomorrow we do have communion. So whatever you need to do to prepare for that, if you have some phone calls that you need to make tonight, just to set things right, go ahead and make that, do that, because we want to come to communion with a heart of worship, with a heart that is open to God. So just a reminder, we do have communion tomorrow, and we would love to have you all here. And I think those are the announcements I have for today. So happy Sabbath, everyone. Good night.